The axolotl possesses the secret of eternal youth, living its whole life essentially as a larva. It stays underwater, keeping its gills. It also has an uncanny ability to regenerate. If an axolotl loses an arm, a leg, or even parts of an organ, the missing piece can regrow. The animals have long fascinated the people of Mexico. In order to absorb the animals' miraculous powers, people ate them and used them as medicine. This tradition continues today. Dominican nuns living near Lake Pátzcuaro breed the salamanders and use their skin to make a cough syrup according to an old secret recipe. It is said to be effective against coughs, anemia, and, because of its high protein content, to provide energy for nursing mothers and the elderly. A whole range of ethnopharmaceutical applications involve amphibians, ways that indigenous peoples use the animals to fight various diseases. Usually the toxins in the animal's skins are not stable enough to really be active after someone swallows them. Even so, indigenous medicine has always been and continues to be an important source of new active ingredients. Skin toxins from amphibians are analyzed worldwide. Some scientists hope that the venom of poison dart frogs could yield new painkillers. One active ingredient, epibatidine, much stronger than morphine, was developed from the venom of the three-striped tree creeper frog and made it into clinical trials. Axolotls were one of the first species that scientists used as laboratory animals. Most lab axolotls are white, the result of a natural mutation that gives the animals dark eyes and unpigmented skin, which is particularly easy to examine under the microscope. Researchers hope the animals will help them uncover the secret of regeneration.